Can you tell us a little bit about the evolution of the slow reveal graph and kind of how your thinking around data science has evolved?
I think I've always been really interested in data. The first time I saw a slow reveal graph done, it was actually by Brian Bouchard, and he had called them numberless graphs. And he had taken a graph and removed all of the contextual information. So it was just bars. And then after revealing that to kids, revealed a little bit more information, maybe what the categories of these different bars were. And then progressively revealed more and more information and encouraged students to talk about it. And so I decided to try it out with my own class. I actually was teaching a sixth grade class at that time. I'm back teaching sixth grade again this year. And it was really fascinating to see how they interacted with it, how they were able to attend to different things when pieces of the graph had been stripped away and decontextualized. And then they then made sense of the context as it kept getting added back. And that they really had such profound noticings that I don't think they would have had if I'd revealed the whole thing to them at the very beginning.
That's fantastic. I think anyone who hears like profound noticings, your words there, is going to be intrigued about how to make that happen with their own students.